Hey, it's Tom from Pack Hacker, and in this video, we're taking a detailed look at the Air Split Kit that I've been testing over the course of the last 2 weeks. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up so we can keep helping you find the right gear. Let's get into it. Okay, so the primary fabric we have going on here is Air's classic 1680D Cordura Ballistic Nylon. And that's this basket weave fabric that you're gonna see around the entirety of it. As far as other materials go, we have some Hypalon right here in the form of an Air tag. And then we have a Hypalon zipper garage here on the front to just help keep out additional moisture. This is a self-locking YKK AquaGuard zipper. And then this is a reverse coil AquaGuard zipper as well. Reverse coil, so you can't see the zipper teeth. Zipper teeth are actually on the inside. All right, so the exterior is pretty simple. And the thing I like about this pouch is it's a relatively small footprint with some expandability options too. One notable piece on the outside is just this little handle here for either carrying it around or hanging it up. I like that it's there. Honestly, I could do without, or maybe it's either smaller or bigger. You know, my hand can get in here, but it's not quite handle size. I would even maybe want it a tad bit smaller for my personal use, just so it was like more of a small loop where you could hang it up. But that's just me being nitpicky. And I do think it's good. It's nice to have that functionality. All right, and then now the big part about this that I wanna show you is, and the reason why it's called the split kit is you can turn it into a bit of a triangle and open things up a little bit more. Cool thing about this is when it's in this mode, you can set it next to you on the table. So I use this, I mean, depending on what you pack inside of here, it's kind of hard to compress electronics, but I like to get everything inside the way I want it. And if you kind of layer it up correctly, you can zip this up and then create a smaller footprint for your pouch. It's kind of like the way a compression packing cube works, though it depends on what you have inside. I have a lot of hard electronics, so you just need to lay everything out very mindfully. This front pocket here on the front of it is made lined with mesh. So I have a ton of just little stuff in here. I've got some wired headphones in case my wireless headphones run out of battery and I can't charge them for some reason, just like a lighter. And then I have a lot of small dongles in here. I feel like it's not really solved for small dongles for me. I usually have like a smaller pouch where I keep these in, just for my needs, small dongles and like a thumb drive. But yeah, see, I don't really know. See, there's one more in there. In here, like I wouldn't really do this because it's black on black. And then also, you know, it's just harder to see. So I'll typically have these in a smaller pouch and I'll just put them off to the side. And just put the pouch in here. So then I can keep them separate and get access to them when I need them in a bit of a smaller package. But yeah, I think that's it for the inside of this thing. So let me just open up the main compartment now and I'll just talk about the interiors in a second. But you can see here that I kind of had the packing strategy going. So a lot of these bigger items in this front mesh pocket were down here because there's a little bit of extra room where I have this charging cable for my laptop and then big MacBook Pro brick, right? If you got a MacBook Pro, you know what I'm saying. And then we have a just an anchor battery bank as well. So one of the things that I wanna bring up is, yeah, just being very mindful of how you pack it. So I had these on this end, which left a lot of room for this stretchy mesh to go into the main compartment. And I really love that. It's so simple, but it adds a ton of versatility to the way that you are able to pack. Typically, I am carrying around a Topo Designs gear accessory pouch, but this honestly might take the place of it. I think maybe one con, depending on the items that you are carrying around with you, is that it's round on the sides. So with this charger, I mean, it still fits in just fine, but it is round on the sides. So you're not quite optimizing the space as a square like you are in the Topo Designs accessory pouch. And yeah, but I just think that added versatility is good. And just let me give you an idea of how big this thing can really get. So you can see there's that excess fabric on the bottom there that kind of compresses and it goes into kind of standing pouch mode here. And then you have that stretchy mesh, which can stretch, you know, almost across the entirety of the pouch. So you have so much versatility. If you want to put small flat items in here, that totally works. If you want to put in something bulkier, like even this could go on this side, and you can see with that zipped up, it's just cutting into that main compartment, but you have so much room. I mean, we could probably even almost stack headphones on top of this too. Maybe not quite. Is it gonna fit? There we go. And yeah, I mean, you can really see this starting to jut into that main portion of the pouch, but you can segment it as you need it. It's very flexible, which I like. And that about covers it. That is the Air Split Kit. Super simple design with a lot of versatility, a lot more than I was initially expecting. So I do like it. Also, I just realized I didn't really talk about the zipper pulls. So we have Hypalon here that's been folded over, a nice grippy grab to it. And then we have Air's standard larger zipper pull up here for that main compartment opening. So there you have it, the Air Split Kit. Thanks for competing here at Pack Hacker, your guide to smarter travel, and we will see you in the next video.